بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الناصح الأمين. اللهم صل على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ومن تمسك بسنته إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. We continue going over the tremendous book by the Imam Mujaddid Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab رحمه الله تعالى. Before getting into the next issue, we would like to look at the dalil for al-muwala, that it has to be a consistency when doing the wudu, that it has to be consistent. And the proof that it has to be consistent and that each part has to be washed in its totality. And as mentioned in the last week's class, the ulama, they mentioned that it has to be washed in such a manner that, yani, or with the consistency that the limb, the previous limb, does not dry before moving on to the next limb. And that if anything is missing, na'am, then this will have an effect. And the proof of this is the hadith sahibu lum'ah, is the hadith of the individual who had a lum'ah, he had a dry patch, or the owner of the dry patch. And in Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as it comes on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, annahu lamma ra'a rajulan fi qadamihi lum'atan qadra dirham لم يصبها الماء فأمره بالإعادة. This hadith, as it comes, the hadith on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that once, or when he saw that a man who was making the wudu, yani who made the wudu, that there was a portion of dry or dry patch on his foot that was the size of a dirham. It was the size of a dirham in which no water had touched it. No water had touched it. To which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he told the man to complete all of the wudu. To complete the whole of the wudu. Na'am. And this is a proof and an evidence that it has to be a consistency when making the wudu. And if there is a break in that consistency, such as the limb, the previous limb, has become dry before getting to the next limb, then that person will have to start the wudu from the beginning. He will have to start his wudu from the beginning. Na'am. And we understand that understanding from this particular narration. Tayyib. So it has to be a consistency. That a person, he goes from one body part to the next body part. He goes from one body part to the next body part. Tayyib. Also, this would bring us to the next issue, as the Imam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions, and this is the issue that is dealing with the tasmiyah. As the Imam, he says, وَوَاجِبُهُ التَّسْمِيَّةُ مَعَ الذِّكْرِ, that it is incumbent to make the tasmiyah. The tasmiyah, as the Fudilat al-Shaykh al-Allama Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahullah Ta'ala, he mentions that the tasmiyah, then it is to say Bismillah. Naam, the tasmiyah, it is to say Bismillah. He says, وَإِن زَادَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ فَلَا بَأْسَ, that a person, prior to making the wudu, then he will say Bismillah. Or he will say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Naam, before making the wudu, a person, he will say Bismillah. Or he will say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Naam. Now, of course, this is in those situations where he is not prevented from doing such. Meaning that if he is inside of the bathroom, and when we mean here by the bathroom, we mean the bathroom that is not separated and the toilet is present in the same room. We're not speaking about those, some of the modern styles of bathrooms where the toilet is in a separate room all to itself. And we say modern, any modern in the Western world, because traditionally in the Muslim world, the toilet is a separate area from where the sink will be, yani where a person will, you know, wash their hands and, you know, so on and so forth. The toilet is usually a separate room that has its door, and it's a separate room, yani it's separate, right? So in a bathroom such as this, then an individual, he's free to say Bismillah. There's nothing preventing him from saying that. But in the older style bathrooms in the West, where you have the toilet right next to the sink and the like, then in this situation, it is not befitting to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's name in such a setting. It's not yani befitting to mention the name of Allah in such a setting. So there, he will be prevented from saying the basmala. He will be prevented from the tasmiyah, and that is to say Bismillah. Why? Because the toilet is there, and thus it will be prevented. Naam. Sheikh Fawzan, he mentions that as relates to the tasmiyah itself, yani the hukum of the tasmiyah, he says, وَقَدْ اخْتَلَفَ الْعُلَمَاءُ فِي الْحُكْمِ التَّسْمِيَةِ, that the ulama, they differ about what is the ruling of the tasmiyah فِي ابْتِدَاءِ الْوُضُوء, at the beginning of the wudu, when a person begins the wudu. هَلْ هِيَ الْوَاجِبَةِ أَوْ سُنَّةِ, is it wajiba, is it obligatory, or is it sunnah, is it recommended? Is it obligatory, or is it recommended? Naam. The Imam, rahimahullah ta'ala, he goes with the opinion that it is obligatory. Naam. He goes with the opinion that the tasmiyah, it is obligatory, that prior to making the wudu, then a person, he must say Bismillah. And this is found in his statement, or we understand this from his statement, وَوَاجِبُهُ التَّسْمِيَةِ, that it is wajib to say the tasmiyah. Naam. وَوَاجِبُهُ التَّسْمِيَةُ مَعَ الذِّكْرِ, that is wajib that a person, he says the tasmiyah along with dhikr, some other remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam. Sheikh Fawzan, حفظه ta'ala, without getting into which one is the strongest of the opinions and so on and so forth, he mentions that without doubt, yani, with the vast majority, or yani, without doubt, عند الجميع, نعم, that without doubt, with all of the ulama, all of the ulama, نعم, all of the imams of the religion, all of the ulama, they all agree that saying the basmala before the wudu, it is mashru'ah, it is legislated. That saying the basmala before the wudu, it is legislated. Naam. Whether that legislation is with the ruling of obligation, or whether that legislation is with the ruling of recommendation, everybody agrees that it is legislated, it is from the deen, that before the wudu, then a person, he is to say Bismillah. And as Sheikh Fawzan mentioned, if he will add to it Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, so he will add to it ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, then this is no problem. There's no problem with regards to this. The Fudil to Sheikh Al-Allama, Sheikh Abdul Muhsin Al-Anbad, حفظه الله تعالى, he mentions يعني هذا أحد الأقوال في المسألة, meaning and commenting on the statement of the Imam Muhammad bin Abdul Wahhab, as he says, وواجبه التسمية مع الذكر, that it is wajib to say the tasmiyah along with the dhikr. He said that this is one of the statements inside of this issue. This is أحد الأقوال, this is one of the statements في المسألة, inside of this issue. وهو رواية عن Imam Ahmad and Al-Imam Ahmad. And this is a narration on Imam Ahmad, meaning in the Hanbali Madhab, you have one narration that from, yani that goes back to Imam Ahmad, that speaks of the obligation, that this is the opinion inside of the Madhab, and that is, it is obligatory to make the tasmiyah before the wudu. And remember, the tasmiyah, it is to say, Bismillah. Na'am. وَمِمَّا قَالَ بِهِ الْحَسَنُ وَإِسْحَاقُ, and this is, was the opinion of Al-Hasan and Ishaq. وَقَوْلُ الثَّانِ, and the second opinion, أَنَّ الْتَسْمِيَةَ مُسْتَحَبَّةَ, is that the tasmiyah is recommended. Is that the tasmiyah is recommended. And this opinion of the recommendation of the tasmiyah, that it is recommended, هُوَ قَوْلٌ جَمْهُورِ الْعُلَمَاءِ, this is the statement of the majority of the scholars. The majority of the scholars, they see the tasmiyah as being mustahabba, that it is recommended. Naam. So the majority of Ahlul Ilm, then they are under the opinion that the tasmiyah is recommended. Naam. That is recommended. طيب. وَهُوَ يعني نعم. Then you have وَإِحْدَى روايتين عن الإمام أحمد, and this also has been narrated on Imam Ahmad. So inside of the Hanbali Madhab, basically we have two opinions, or both opinions have been narrated on Imam Ahmad. One opinion that states that it is obligatory to say Bismillah before the wudu, and another narration that says it is recommended. So you have one narration on Imam Ahmad that says it's obligatory to say the wudu, Bismillah before the wudu, and you have another narration on Imam Ahmad that says it is recommended to say Bismillah before the wudu. So both opinions have come, and are mentioned inside of the Hanbali Madhab. Naam. Whereas the vast majority of the scholars, and they go with the latter narration that has been يعني narrated on Imam Ahmad, and that is that it is recommended. نعم وذكر ذلك في المغني, and this was mentioned inside of the famous book of Hanbali Fiqh, which is entitled المغني. وقد ورد في التسمية في الوضوء حديث, and there are some ahadith that come inside mentioning the tasmiyah of the wudu. For example, the hadith akhrajahu Abu Dawood, the hadith that has been collected by Abu Dawood and Abi Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, on the authority of Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا وضوء لمن لم يذكر اسم الله عليه, that there is no wudu for the one who does not mention Allah's name upon it. That there is no wudu for the one who does not mention Allah's name upon it. نعم. وذكر الشيخ الألباني أنه حسن. And Sheikh Al-Albani, he mentions that this particular hadith, then its grading is that this particular hadith is Hasan. That this particular hadith is Hasan. نعم. وقال, and he said, وَقَدْ قَوَّاهُ الْحَافِظُ الْمُنْذَرِ وَالْأَسْقَلَانِ وَحَسَّنَهُ إِبْنُ الصَّلَاحِ وَإِبْنُ كِثِيرٍ وَالْعِرَاقِ. And Shaykh al-Bani, he mentions in Irwa al-Ghanil that this hadith, it is strengthened, نعم, it was strengthened, يعني meaning by other narrations, as mentioned by al-Hafidh al-Mundhari, and also Al-Asqalani, and it was graded as being Hasan by Ibn al-Salah, نعم, and also Ibn Kathir and also Al-Iraqi. فابن الصلاح وابن كثير والعراقي, they all grade this hadith as being حسن. نعم, as being حسن. واختيار الشيخ القول بالوجوب مع الذكر. And Sheikh Abdul Muhsin, he mentions that the Sheikh, meaning the Imam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, he took the opinion and he went with the opinion of the obligation of saying the tasmiyah along with dhikr. Naam. وفيه الاحتياط والخروج من الخلاف. He took that opinion, the Shaykh he mentions, he says, because in it, then this is to go on the safe side. Naam. This is to be cautious. This is the cautious opinion, and it will remove an individual from any type of khilaf, from any type of differing. Because regardless of whether it is yani mustahab, if a person deems it as being wajib and he always says it, then khalas, la ba's, he always said it. So if it was mustahab, no problem, it's still covered. Naam. So from the standpoint of being cautious and yani and that and taking caution, then he went with the opinion of the obligation of saying the basmala, that is just you say it every time. Naam. And of course, this is in the situations where you are not prevented from doing such, like the situation where we mentioned with the toilet being present inside of the bathroom. Now, before getting into the nawaqib al-wudu, before getting into those things which will break the wudu, because after mentioning those obligations and things in which we have to wash, those body parts in which we have to wash inside of the wudu, then it is only right that we move on prior to getting into that which would break the wudu. And we mention the hikmah or the wisdom on why in the wudu we washed the body parts that we washed. And this is a very beautiful benefit that the Fadilat Shaykh Al-Allama, Shaykh Salih Al-Fawzan, Hafidhahullah Ta'ala, he mentions after speaking about the tasmiyah and whether or not, or about the tasmiyah and explaining to us what it is and the manner in which we are to say it, or its description, by saying Bismillah, or it's okay for us to add to it Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. And likewise, while confirming and teaching us that it is legislated, whether it is wajib or it is mustahab, then it is legislated inside of the deen. فَلَا يَنْبَغِي تَرْكُهَا, so it is yani, it is not befitting that it should be left, regardless whether it is wajib or it is sunnah, is from the religion, is legislated, so it should not be left. Naam. If an individual has the ability to do it, then he should do it. If he's in a situation which allows as such, then he should do it. He should say Bismillah. Naam. The Shaykh, he says, Wal hikmah wallahu a'lam. He said, in the wisdom, and Allah knows best, fi ikhtisas hadhihi al-a'dha' al-arba' bil-wudu. He says, and the wisdom, and Allah knows best, for the choosing of these body parts when making the wudu, لِأَنَّهَا أَسْرَعُ مَا يَتَحَرَّقُ مِنَ الْبَدْنِ. نعم. Because this is يعني, from the quickest of what is moved from the, that can be moved from the body. لِكْتِسَابِ الذُّنُوبِ. نعم. That these are the body parts that are the quickest to be utilized and set into motion to what? To do sins. To do these sins. Naam. So reflect on the body parts that we wash in the wudu, and you will see that these are the body parts primarily that are utilized in the commission of a sin, when doing a sin. Naam. The Shaykh, he says, فَكَانَ فِي التَّضْحِيرِ ظَاهِرِهَا تَنْبِيهٌ عَلَى تَضْحِيرِ بَاطِنِهَا. He said, and verily with the washing, the external washing of these body parts, then it will draw our attention and give notice for us to what? To cleanse these same body parts internally. Now, physical and literal and literal cleansing of these body parts will thus remind us to what? To clean these body parts internally, and to, for lack of a better term, to figuratively clean these body parts. Now, to clean these body parts, so that they are only utilized in that which is halal. وقد أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن المسلم كلما غسل عضوا منها. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he informed us that every time a Muslim, he washes a body part from these body parts, يعني حط عنه, يعني في الوضوء, inside of the wudu, حط عنه كل خطيئة أصابها بذلك العضو, that whatever sin that that particular part had done will be washed, يعني would come off of it. نعم. So these sins that are made by these body parts, then those sins fall off while a person is making the wudu. وَأَنَّهَا تَخْرُجُ, and that it would move off of this person, خَطَايَاهُ, his sins, مَعَ الْمَا, his sins will come off with the water. So as the water is coming off from the face, whatever sins that have been made by the face, يعني, it is coming off with those drops of water. أو مع آخر القطر الماء, and all the way until the last drop of water that falls from the limbs. So the drops of water and the water that falls from the limbs while making the wudu, then it is getting rid of the sins that were done and committed by way of those body parts. And this, and the hadith which mentioned this, it could be found in Sahih Muslim. Now it could be found in Sahih Muslim. ثم أرشد, and then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he guided us to the fact, يعني بعد الغسل هذه الأعضاء, that after we complete from the washing of these body parts, نعم, إلى تجديد الإيمان بالشهادتين, that after we wash these body parts, then we should renew our iman by articulating the shahadatain. That we should renew our iman by articulating the shahadatain. وَإِشَارَةً إِلَى الْجَمْعِ بَيْنَ الْطَهَارَتَيْنِ, and that we are to combine between the purifying, we should combine between the two purifying agents, or يعني the two purifying factors, الحسية والمعنوية, that we should combine between the purification, the physical purification, نعم, and also the in other words, the tangible purification and the intangible purification. So we should combine between the tangible purification and the intangible purification. نعم. The Shaykh, he mentions, فالحسية, so that tangible purification, تكون بالماء على الصفة التي بيّنها الله في كتابه. Then the physical purification, or the tangible purification, then this will be by way of water. That which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has explained inside of his book. نعم. ومن من غسل هذه الأعضاء, and that is from washing these body parts. From washing these body parts that were mentioned. ومعنوية, and the intangible purification, نعم, the intangible purification, تكون بالشهادتين, then this will be by the شهادتين, that the شهادتين, in which it is from the sunnah to articulate it upon the completion of the wudu, نعم, اللتين تطهران من الشرك, the شهادتين, that it purifies from the shirk, it purifies from the shirk. وقد قال تعالى, and الله تعالى في آخر آية الوضوء, at the end of the ayah of wudu from Surah Al-Ma'idah, الله تعالى, he says, ما يريد الله ليجعل عليكم من حرج, that Allah does not want to put any difficulties upon you. وَلَكِنْ يُرِيدُ لِيُطَهِّرَكُمْ But rather, Allah, He wants to purify you. وَلِيُتَمَّ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ And that Allah wants to complete His favor upon you so that you will be thankful. Or so perhaps you will be thankful. Na'am, so that you can be thankful. وَهَكَذَا أَيُّهَا الْمُسْلِمِ And like this is it, O Muslim. شَرَّعَ اللَّهُ لَكَ الْوُضُوءُ That Allah, He has legislated for you the wudu. لِيُطَهِّرَكَ So as to purify you. بِهِ مِنَ الْخَطَيَاكَ So that Allah can purify you by way of your wudu from your sins. So this, yani, subhanAllah, is something that is tremendous. That every time a person, he makes the wudu, then his sins are coming off of him. His sins are coming off of him. So this is an encouragement for what? For an individual to be steadfast and preservant of his wudu. And to always stay in a state of wudu. And when he breaks his wudu, to hurry up to make the wudu. And also, the Shaykh, he mentions, Shaykh Fawzan, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by way of the wudu, He purifies for us, yani, our sins. Na'am. وَلِيُتَمَّ بِهِ نِعْمَتَهُ عَلَيْكَ And also for Allah to complete His favor upon you. To complete His favor upon you. And also the Shaykh, he mentions, وَتَأَمَّنْ And pay attention, reflect. افتتاح الآية That the way the ayah, it begins. Na'am. Look at the way the ayah of wudu, it begins. The ayah of wudu, it begins with a nida. It begins with a call. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling people. But Allah is not calling all of the people. Na'am, because you have certain nida inside of the Quran. Where Allah ta'ala, He says, Ya ayyuhan nas. Na'am. O human beings. Yeah, as in Allah Ta'ala's statement, Ya أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ Like in Allah Ta'ala's statement, O human beings, worship your Lord who created you. Now, worship your Lord who created you. To the end of the ayah. So this address here is for what? All of mankind. Now, but in the ayah of wudu, Allah does not address all of mankind. Because when you say, Oh, yani in the call or in the nida of Ya ayyuhan nas, all human beings, then this includes all the human beings, the believers from amongst them and the disbelievers. Everybody is being addressed. But here in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He does not address all the human beings, but rather He addresses who? He addresses the believers from them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins the ayah of wudu by saying, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. O you who believe. Na'am. So the address here is for those who believe. Na'am. وَقَدْ وَجَّهُ سُبْحَانُهُ وَتَعَالَى الْخِطَابِ إِلَى مَنْ يَتَّصِفُ بِالْإِيمَانِ So Allah, He has made the address here in this ayah, addressing those who They have the characteristic of Iman. Those who have adorned themselves with Al-Iman. Those who believe. لِأَنَّهُ هُوَ الَّذِي يُصْغِي لِأَوَامِرِ اللَّهِ Because these are the ones who are going to incline to Allah's commands. وَيَنْتَفِعُ بِهَا And those who will benefit by way of them. نعم وَلِهَذَا And due to this, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said as it comes in a hadith that has been collected by Ibn Hibban wa Ahmad wa Ibn Majah wa sahaha yani matnuhu al-Dhahabi and Imam al-Dhahabi he said that the text of the hadith is authentic and that is the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يحافظ على الوضوء إلا مؤمن. The statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that none will safeguard their wudu except for the true believer. that no one safeguards his wudu except for the true believer. Na'am. And the ulama, they mention that what is meant by the safeguarding of the wudu, then this means to what? Then this means to remain, or not remain, but to always make sure we stay in a state of wudu. So when we break the wudu, to make wudu again. When we break the wudu, to make wudu again. Na'am. So when we break the wudu, make the wudu again. And this is from the characteristics of those who truly believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And like this is how we want to be, ya ibad, constantly in a state of wudu, so that we are always prepared and ready to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we are always prepared to make salah, na'am, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by way of the salah. Na'am, by way of the salah. The Shaykh, he mentions, and this is just for a benefit for us, وَمَا زَادَ عَمَّا ذُكِرَ فِي صِفَةِ الْوُضُوءِ, and that which is goes beyond what was described for the wudu, meaning inside of the ayah. فَهُوَ مُسْتَحَبٌ, that it is مُسْتَحَب. Na'am, that it is مُسْتَحَب. طيب. Which now this brings us to the sunan of the wudu. The sunan of the wudu. And بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, before getting into the nawaqib, then just briefly, we will mention the sunan of the wudu. But بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, we will save that to the next class, so as to not make it too long. خير كلام ما قل ودل, the best of the speech is that which is short and to the point. لا تطيل فيمل, do not be long-winded, because then it would spark boredom. Now then the people will get bored. So we will suffice ourselves with that. فنكتفي بهذا القدر. وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وجزاكم الله خيرا.